fresher than a mountain stream. The greatest coffee ever seen. It's the Buffalo Bean.
Once again, through the magic of radio, Buffalo Bean Coffee takes you back in history. The date is October 11th, 1908, where we find Lighthouse Keeper Ludlow and his assistant Todd receiving their winter supplies for the remainder of the shipping season.
Ludlow!
Luddy!
Lightkeeper Ludlow, I pulled the provisions up by the tram, and they're ready to be counted and accounted for.
Oh, great, Todd. We've been running low on supplies. I'll count them off for you to check.
Okay, Ludlow. I've got the list and the fountain pen.
Okay, 50 pounds beans.
Check.
Salt pork, 2 barrels.
Check.
Half a barrel lard.
Check.
1 ladies' home journal. Todd, what are you buying a ladies' home journal for?
Oh, give me that, Ludlow.
Todd?
I just thought it would give me some ideas on how to tidy things up around here a bit.
Well, what do you mean, Todd? We passed all inspections this year.
Well, I was thinking of some possible other color schemes and, well, maybe some nice table settings.
Todd, we got Coast Guard issued whitewash, and that's what we make do with.
But don't throw the magazine away, Ludlow. I just want to read it.
Well, okay. But don't be changing too much around here.
Okay, let's get back to the list.
Okay. Sugar, 25 pounds.
Check.
Coffee.
Check.
Wait, coffee? What is this?
It's coffee, Ludlow.
Don't you notice anything, Todd?
Yeah, coffee.
Think about it, Todd.
What?
That is not the bean. That's not the Buffalo Bean. These bags are labeled coffee, not Buffalo Bean coffee. There is no buffalo on these bags.
No, I think...
Yes, you didn't specify the bean, did you?
Well, I didn't.
Don't make excuses, Todd. You're a good assistant, but this is one mistake I'm going to have to write you up for. We can't keep up the pace of this place without the Buffalo Bean coffee.
Ludlow, I know we like the bean, but we've got coffee, and we got a lot of it.
That's just the point. We'll have to account for every ounce of this, and they won't reprovision us for a month.
But
I'd rather have no coffee at all, none. If it ain't the bean, it ain't worth brewing.
But Ludlow,
take all that coffee and feed it to the fish.
That's our only coffee.
Todd, that's an order. Get rid of it. Take it back down on the tram and dump it over. There is no cure for the lack of the bean, the buffalo bean.
Todd lowered the tram, and for the first time, he felt a failure as Ludlow's assistant. He dumped the tram all at once when he noticed the buffalo bean label on the other side of the bag.
Oh, no, it is buffalo bean, and it's sinking to the bottom. Ludlow, come down quick. Hurry up. Bring the nets and the hooks. We got to get it. It's the bean. It is the bean.
What did you do, Todd?
Just what you told me, but it is the bean. The buffalo label was on the back.
You threw buffalo bean into Lake Superior? Now there'll be another write-up, Todd.
Let's see if we can retrieve it.
It's too late, Todd. The bean has met its best friend, water. I guess you just gave it to the fish.
That year was the best fishing around the lighthouse in recorded history. And as luck would have it, our friends survived the season. You see, Todd had found a delightful recipe for boiled fish in his lady's home journal. Buffalo Bean Coffee, the only coffee with a kick in every sip. For a copy of Todd's boiled fish recipe, The Fish on Bean, visit BuffaloBeanCoffeeCompany.com.
The greatest coffee ever seen. It's the Buffalo Bean.
This is David Parsons from Grand Marais, and you're listening to the Madeline Island Radio Hour.